is, I checked it. Welcome.
Hello.
Can you hear me back there?
It is working.
What?
Yeah, I know, sorry. I think I got it working this morning, but if the battery dies, we'll need to run back there and turn the unit off because it's loud.
I don't think it's on.
I don't think it's working.
It's not working now?
No.
I don't think it's on, but we can hear you.
Oh.
But do you need it for this?
I don't need it, well, it helps with that. I probably should have checked the volume on that, I appreciate you bringing that up. Let me just quick check.
I don't think it's on.
I'll turn the.
Is it back in?
It seemed to be earlier, but that's, it's not making a loud noise, so.
Funny, yeah, it's on.
Let me just.
Here, you want me to?
I think it's up pretty high.
Well, if it starts being steady, I'll run back.
It's user problem.
Here's my track speed.
We'll get this worked out eventually with this mic. So welcome, I'm glad you're here today. We're small, but we're mighty. And welcome to people online as well. Today is Christ the King Sunday. That crowns the end of our church year. In a way, this is the church's New Year's Eve worship. So welcome to church's New Year's Eve. I invite you to consider your faith journey during this past year and your hopes and dreams for the year to come. Share with others this coming week the best things that happened, peaks, the worst things that happens, pits, and where you saw God praises during this past year. Couple of announcements. Happy Thanksgiving to you all this week. We're not doing our traditional worship this year with pie, but you'll all be in our hearts, and we look forward to next year. And the season of Advent begins next Sunday, so we'll start to move into the Christmas season. Any other announcements today? Food Shelf Sunday will be next in 2 weeks, I think, now. So,
peanut butter always welcome.
Yeah, peanut butter. Anything else that you know of? Or? Nope. Okay.
She always likes peanut butter, so.
Yeah, peanut butter is good, and it's very useful. Any other announcements for the good of the group? If not, I invite you to stand for opening words of faith. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth.
Worship
the Lord with gladness. Come to God's presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is God that made us, and we are God's.
We are God's people and the sheep of God's pasture. Enter God's gates with thanksgiving and God's courts with praise.
Give thanks to God, bless God's name. For the Lord is good, God's steadfast love endures forever,
and
God's faithfulness to all generations. And let us pray. King of kings, sovereign above all, though we have moved on in this world from such ancient language, we remember our ancestors who struggled to survive among wars and exiles and saw you as king, who would never fail them, the one who ruled above all. Write your word upon our hearts so that we need no scroll, no book, no script to know that you love us. Show us the power of your covenant that you will be faithful to us even when we fail to remain faithful to you. Amen. And let us pray together these words. You are a source of light and love, in whom we live, move, and have our being. There is no other God. There is no other way for us than your way, which is love. Through your love, may we learn how to love one another.
Through your forgiveness, may we learn how to forgive.
Through your ways of peace, may we seek justice, practice loving kindness, and move forward in humility with you. For the beauty of your word inscribed upon us, we pray.
In
the name of one whose body and blood became your new covenant with us, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. Amen. to be seated as we listen to our opening hymn.
If you'd like to join, if you, I guess not join, if you'd like to, I'm going to do some, if you'd like to follow along with the words, we're going to do Amazing Grace, number 779.
Children of God, grace, mercy, and peace be with you all. I invite you to share God's peace with one another this morning, safely, for a moment.
Yeah, peace now. Peace to you.
And then let's take a moment to do the song "Breathe."
Join in on the organ. We got
awesome.
Working.
The organ works now. That's right.
Well, knock on wood. The last we tried it.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, I need a videographer. forego our children's sermon today. We'll get that in the, give it to you in the sermon today. And so is there any joys and concerns this morning? Prayer requests or birthdays, anniversaries?
It was Zach's birthday here recently.
Zach? How old are you, Zach?
Oh, 14.
Well, awesome, awesome.
Monday?
Awesome. Monday. Well, great. Happy birthday. Any other joys or concerns? I know I have a joy to share. I spoke with Jean yesterday. She's doing great after her surgery and is feeling really good. She's getting up and about. So that's good news. Things went well. And we'll keep her in our prayers today. Going once, twice, everybody good? Continue our service with sharing the words of the Apostles' Creed. I invite you to stand as you're able. We are one faith, one baptism, and united in Christ, we confess our faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our petitions today will end with, hear us, O God, and you will respond. Your mercy is great. And let us pray. Longing for Christ's reign to come among us, we pray for the outpouring of God's power on the church, the world, and all in need. Sovereign of all, train our ears to hear your cry in the needs of those around us. Bless all the ministries of the church and the greater church through which we seek to serve other people as ourselves have been served. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You cause rain to fall on the just and the unjust alike. Direct our use of creation to provide for the needs of all people in ways that are sustainable for the earth. Bring peace to every place where conflict rages. Remember today in the Middle East as they recently had another bombing, and those who are in quarantine across the globe. Grant opportunities for ending divisions among us and usher in your reign of unity and reconciliation. Hear us, O God. Heal us the sinful divisions we erect between us and release us from systems of oppression and prejudice. Restore our capacity to see your image in those whose dignity has been stripped away. Pour out the gifts of your Spirit on children and youth throughout the church. We pray for all those who work in children's ministry, youth ministry, and campus ministries these days, as they nurture the gifts of these people, upcoming adults. We especially pray, healing God, for your mercy upon those who are suffering from seasonal affective disorder, depressions, PTSD, anxiety, fears, those who are facing surgeries or recovering from surgeries, all those who work in healthcare, Lord, serving other people, and also all birthdays and anniversaries, Lord. Thank you for the time to give thanks together this week as families. Lord, make those nights special for us. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Receive now all our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, until that day when you gather your creation around your throne, where you reign forever and ever. Amen. And I invite you, if you didn't pick up your communion items, to get those now, and we will join together in another communion. I'll get mine open. You want to peel off that top to use that wafer. Jesus took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And after supper, he gave thanks. He took the cup and gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." And remember us into your kingdom, Lord, and teach us to pray anew. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And the body of Christ is given for you. And the blood of Christ is shed for you. Now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace now and forever. Amen. I invite you to be seated as we listen to our hymn of the day.
Hymn of the day will be hymn number 856. This was Susie's request in honor of her grandmother, who she said would ask her to play it. Usually this time of year, correct?
Yes.
Let's go out to your grandma. Thank you.
to them, all of them may turn from their evil ways, so that I may forgive their iniquity and their sin. Then Jeremiah called Baruch, son of Neriah, and Baruch wrote on a scroll at Jeremiah's dictation all the words of the Lord that he had spoken to him. And Jeremiah ordered Baruch, saying, I am prevented from entering the house of the Lord. So you go yourself, and on a fast day in the hearing of the people in the Lord's house, you shall read the words of the Lord from a scroll that you have written at my dictation. You shall read them also in the hearing of all the people of Judah who came up from their towns. It may be that their plea will come before the Lord, and that all of them will turn from their evil ways. For great is the anger and wrath that the Lord has pronounced against this people. And Baruch, son of Neriah, did all that the prophet Jeremiah ordered him about reading from the scroll the words of the Lord in the Lord's house. Then the king sent Jehudi to get the scroll, and he took it from the chamber of Elishama, the secretary. And Jehudi read it to the king and all the officials who stood beside the king. Now the king was sitting in his winter apartment. It was the ninth month, and there was a fire burning in the brazier before him. As Jehudi read three or four columns, the king would cut them off with a penknife and throw them into the fire in the brazier until the entire scroll was consumed in the fire that was in the brazier. So now Jeremiah dictates another. Now, after the king had burned the scroll with the words that Baruch wrote at Jeremiah's dictation, the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah. Take another scroll and write on it all the former words that were in this first scroll, which King Jehoiakim of Judah had burned. A new covenant. The days were surely coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant that I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, a covenant that they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord. But this is a covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer shall they teach one another or say to each other, Know the Lord, for they shall all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, says the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity and remember their sin no more. This is the word of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Natalie, that was a mouthful this morning, a little bit. All of those fancy names. Let us pray. Holy Spirit, we invite you into our midst. We invite you into our minds to think through them, into our ears to hear through them, into our hearts, open them to plant your words deep within us. Encourage us. Inspire us, empower us. In your name, Lord Jesus, we pray. And may the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be pleasing in your sight, O God. So we moved into Jeremiah, and it's kind of interesting this week because we were talking in confirmation about Jeremiah, the times of Jeremiah. The people have gone into captivity in Babylon now. And 70 years they were in captivity. And the interesting parallel today is I think some of us feel like we're in captivity right now. And it's been a tough week. So there was definitely some understanding maybe about what it feels like to not be able to just come and go as you want or be free. Even on a subconscious level, we feel some of that these days. And so as we think about what's going on in Jeremiah's world, he is often his prophecies are often a little bit dark, it seems, and he's mourning at times. You can hear that through his writings. But unlike Jonah, who we talked about a couple weeks ago, he's very bold and preaching his word to those that need to hear it the most. And he today is not able to go to the temple, so he sends his servant Baruch and to read the scroll. And so thinking about the scroll, the scroll has been handwritten. We don't have Office Max or somewhere to copy something to distribute it at this point in time. And it's a cloth scroll or a leather parchment, kind of rolled up, often cloth. Anyway, it took a very long time to work out all of those words. They figure maybe it could have taken up to a year. And often the scribes, as they're going along, sometimes they would cut a little piece out of a scroll if they had an error. So the thinking about how he was bringing it to the king, and the king is cutting it as he's going along. So it's kind of a very graphic image of that fire and that trying to destroy the word of God, kind of. I'll throw it in the fire. That's what I think of it. And so God says, write it again. Which you can imagine it'd be like, what? I gotta write this whole thing again? But they wrote it again. And this word, you know, the thing is, by the time the king got it, it had already been read once, you know, to the public. So the word of God had already gone out. And so what the king meant for harm, in thinking he's destroying it, nobody's going to hear this, not taking it seriously, didn't accomplish anything other than him not hearing what God wanted to say to him directly. And I think sometimes we do that. Sometimes we just discount, you know, what God's trying to say, what God's trying to do. And we're going to focus on the covenant here. And the promise of this new covenant. That's a bright spot of hope. You know, some of the pieces of Jeremiah are very bright in their hope. So after this whole piece of the scroll, you know, for giving God giving a chance to people to repent, to turn from their ways. You know, they were brought to Babylon because they were serving other gods. And they had turned to other sources for their sustenance, for their hope. And so we find a new hope in this new covenant today that God talks about through Jeremiah. And I think it's so relevant to now. We are people that needs to think about hope, to cling to hope. We need to find that hope again within us at times. And we see a lot of people that aren't carrying that hope. And so I say to you today, cling to that hope. Say to your neighbors right now, I'm a person that's clinging to hope. I'm clinging to hope. Say, I'm clinging to hope. So as we think about the new covenant, it's a different covenant. In the past they had, the covenant was based on the Torah, the law, very legalistic. This covenant is a different covenant. This is a covenant between, that's relational, it's personal. He says he's going to put his laws upon your heart. And I'm just curious, do you have Bible verses that you know by heart? You know what? You think of one right off the top of your head?
Galatians 5:22.
What does that say?
Well, live by the Spirit, not by flesh.
Okay. How about you guys? You think of one off the top of your head that you know by heart? Sorry, I'm putting people on the spot. Like the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Maybe trust in the Lord with all your heart. How about you, Jody? I know you know a bunch.
Be still and know that I am God.
Be still. One come to mind for you?
John 3:16.
For God so loved the world. We all know them. You know, they'll start popping into your mind now when you think about them. I mean, some of the ones that the Lord is my rock. We read that one today. I will call upon the Lord who's worthy to be praised. The Lord liveth, and blessed be my rock. The Lord is the light of my salvation. Who shall I fear? The Lord, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, thou art with me. We are given grace upon grace. So that's the kind of thing, you have those words within you. The more that you speak the word, the more that you read the word, the more that word becomes a part of who you are, part of your code, part of how your being is. And it's hard to talk about this and not talk about everything that's happening in the last couple of weeks in our communities, in our state. You know, with all of the cases of the pandemic, people are very much struggling sometimes, that we find in our midst, maybe in the course of our work or in our encounters, and just seeing people is joyous. Seeing just some faces in person on Sunday morning is really exciting. It's like real people, yay. And I was in a meeting with my colleagues at the county in St. Louis this week, and they were saying how, what are you missing? And I said, I miss hugs. You know, I'm a hugger. I just want to hug people. And so there's just all these pieces that, you know, now the things that are really meaningful to people are different maybe than they were 6 months ago even. And so being a person that holds on to hope, you know, if you're a person that clings to hope, you have something that you can give someone that doesn't require touch. It doesn't even require that you're in the same room. Maybe you're on the phone, or maybe you're on a video chat, or whatever you do, but you're able to give them those words that are written in your soul, that you know God is present in the midst of this. That God is a relational God, and God, I have hope, knowing that God will see us through even the tough times. The good times, it's easy to know that God is seeing you through sometimes, but it's the tough times that you have to remember. God says he's with you, even in the fire. And we'll hear a little bit of Daniel next week, so we'll be able to think about those times when even, you know, people were literally put into a fire, but their faith carried them through. And so as I was turning this scripture into my mind this week, and it was quite late that I was getting my sermon together this week because my work was so busy and there was so much brokenness that I encountered this week in people. And I just want to speak into that. You know, I don't know what people are going through, but I know there's people out there even that will listen to this, that will need that word of hope and that strength of knowing that God is coming down. Once again, he's reminding us of the journey as we go into Advent, that he came down for you. He came down for me. He He came down so we could have that relationship instead of having to try to follow a list of Ten Commandments that we never could fulfill. But Jesus came down and fulfilled them for us so that we could try to keep them out of love. But it didn't depend on our salvation then to keep those commandments. Thanks be to God. Because we can't keep them, right? And we do our best. We do our best. And God does the rest. So this humility, he talks about this peace that we bring, you know, to other people each day that we're able to take with us when we go. I had somebody this week say to me, I said, I feel peaceful. And they said, how can you feel peaceful in the midst of everything? You know, people yelling at you or whatever, being frustrated on the phone or in person. And I said, I have confidence. You know, I have confidence, and I start reminding myself when I get overwhelmed by anxiety or if I get overwhelmed by fear, and you know, I don't have a perfect life, so yes, just like you, I struggle with these things. Sometimes fear it's like a wave, right? Right now, sometimes all of a sudden you're fine, and then all of a sudden something just happens, and you kind of go, what just happened? You know, I feel a little bit out of control. I don't know if anybody can relate. But when that happens, you can turn to those words that are written on your heart. Maybe those words that you've pondered and turned over in your mind, and remind yourself about the faithfulness of God. And that God always comes through. So this new covenant says, you will be my people. I will be your God. When you call, I'll answer. And my words will be in you. You know, you don't need that scroll. When the words go out of your mouth, they work. You know, when you speak something, some word of hope to someone, you may not always see the fruit, but God is working that. He's working that with them. If you say, you know, turn to God, that God's in the midst of this with you, time of trial. And I had this epiphany late last night as I was thinking about all this, and that's where I said, through the fire. So what comes out of the fire sometimes is gold. So sometimes we don't know why we're having this trial or why we're going through things. Out of the fire comes gold. Out of pressure, great pressure, comes diamonds. You know, and that's a beautiful thing. You know, we go through these times sometimes and we think, why are we going through these times? And it's a refining almost sometimes, because we push into God farther and he pushes in with us. And something beautiful comes out of it sometimes. Sometimes some new purpose comes out of it, some new understanding of who we are and who we're meant to be. And maybe we become a person that really shines out of that fire. We walk out of that fire glowing with the presence of the Lord. And other people see it. They don't know what it is. Then they ask you and get a chance to tell them. I've been through the fire. I've been through hell in my life. And I've come out on the other side. And we keep hearing that phrase, we're in this together. Well, we really are. We have to lean on each other during these times. We have to open up sometimes and say, you know what? This is a bad week. Or, you know what? I'm struggling with something right now. We like to say, it's a lot. I've heard that a lot lately. It's a lot. You ask somebody how they're doing, it's a lot. And very non-specific, yeah. But ask, so tell me about that. What's a lot? Tell me what's a lot. You know, and maybe it's finances or relationships. Relationships are harder sometimes now because people are not able to be with their loved ones. And the hopefulness is in this that you can still connect. We are in an age where at least you can connect to people via phone, via video. And so I urge you this week to think about how you can be thankful even in the midst of these challenging circumstances by being a person that clings to hope, clings to those words. Because sometimes through the pain comes the greatest gift. For God so loved the world, he gave his son that they pushed that thorny crown on his head, and that blood came down, and through that pain and all that suffering came salvation and the greatest gift of all for you and I, that eternal wiping of the slate, that new beginning, that place where we start that new covenant, where he writes that on our hearts each and every day, every time we turn to him, every time we read our scripture out loud, a piece of that comes in. You may not remember the whole thing perfectly, but those words sink in. God loves me. God loves you. God is faithful. And God will keep God's promises. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, we are a people that need to be encouraged. We need to find hopefulness. Help us to open our hearts to share with others who we are, who our God is, how we can hope in something greater, how we can find peace in the midst of chaos, how we can be a source of strength to those who struggle. You are the light in the darkness that we cling to. Give us your hope and peace as we are sent out today, Lord. In your name we pray, Jesus. Amen. I invite you to stand as you're able as we receive our benediction and our sending song. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you. The Lord look upon you with favor, granting you always his peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you.
Okay.
I haven't announced that yet, so Kendra, so now you know. Tomorrow you'll hear that officially.
I'm actually talking to people.
It's frustrating. I'm so close to it too.
That's awesome. Thanks for supporting them.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Thank you. And all that last one is my favorite.
Oh, just by chance. Seemed like a good, I don't know, it seemed like a good thing. Good. And how great that art. Everyone loves that one.
Got it.
Where did your grandma live? Was she a Floridian as well?
Well,
she
was.
We tried to
keep her out here. Did she grow up in
Alabama? I know. It doesn't work.
Try that 100%.
Really?
And then decide, right?
Are you
yeah,
serious?
That's
she was booked alive in 1860. Oh, yeah, you want to take a bunch of them?
They have
too many, but.
Yeah, we got them in here, didn't you know?
I want to see.
Really? So, like, indentured. Yeah. I got to hear more about that.